Hello, welcome to day 2 of InterGeo 2015, brought to you by the GeoBiz team live from Stuttgart, Germany. The cold autumnly drizzle failed to dampen the spirits at the trade fair as people thronged the mess.
The second day of InterGeo witnessed industry experts discussing recent trends in geodesy, geoinformation and land management. The conversation revolved around current challenges in the geospatial world. Experts talked about the development of Geospatial 4.0 and emergence of integrated solutions. Hexagon President and CEO Ola Roland pointed out people use geospatial technology in everyday life without even realizing it.
I mean, we all use Google Earth, we use Google Maps. I see smartphones in the audience right now. And I mean, if you click on the map there, you can ask for directions and so on. So from being a mystified industry, it's actually something we use every day.
Talking about people power, Ola said he sees a bigger and better future for crowdsourcing data.
We can capture anything and we're going to go to crowdsourcing, and even consumer cameras are going to be used in the future, where we're now increasingly are being able to stitch so-called point clouds from pictures and create 3D realities. So that's not
3D or 4D?
3D or 4D, it doesn't really matter. Yeah, even 5D. But the point with this industry is not the technology. The point is, what are you going to use it for?
Trimble's Geospatial Division GM Ron Desio stressed on how geospatial industry's customer base was changing. He also felt more and more companies are focusing on getting answers out of the data that they capture.
I think where this industry is going to go is that in some cases we're not going to recognize the geospatial professionals of the future, because they're going to be natural resources biologists, they're going to be agronomists, they're going to be many professionals who will use what we've built a life around. They're going to use those as just part of their day. And I think that's actually really exciting, because it gives us as an industry an opportunity to teach these industries about what we do, and to provide services to them, to provide technology, software, professional services, and to be advisors to them in how to capture geospatial data, maintain it, and again, get those answers out that I mentioned before that are going to help them in their industries. I'm very excited about this. I think it's very similar to, if you think about back in the 1970s, the 80s, you'd have computer science degrees, and then just computer science became something that we all do. And I think the same thing with geospatial. I think the notion that geospatial will just be part of coursework and part of people's days.
The spotlight is on unmanned aircraft systems at this year's InterGeo. The exhibition area is buzzing with multi-copters, helicopters and fixed-wing aircrafts. Companies like Regal, Sensefly, Drone Deploy and Spectair are giving live demos of their UAVs. Talk to the manufacturers and you will find that the industry is moving toward integrated surveying solutions. Companies want to provide complete workflow solutions, from flight planning to data evaluation. They are also targeting small and medium enterprises through aggressive pricing strategy and standard solutions.
Bentley Systems has acquired Aeon Software, a company that deals with simulation and integration of natural 3D environments. Aeon Software, View and Plant Factory products are crucial among computer graphic professionals in the media and science industries. Aeon's offerings have been used in the making of numerous blockbuster films, including Avatar, The Hunger Games, The Avengers, Hugo and Terminator. Headed by founder Nicholas Helps, Aeon Software will operate as a subsidiary for Bentley. Greg Bentley, CEO of Bentley Systems, believes that reality modeling for architects and engineers to capture existing conditions and provide context for infrastructure designs can now be enlivened with digital nature.
Topcon Positioning Group has released its Magnet Construct app for Apple devices. Earlier, the app was available only on Android. The free app has been built to drive LN100 layout navigator system. The free Magnet Construct app offers intuitive options to wirelessly connect to and drive an LN100 for fast build measurements, as well as graphical guidance to the design data. Magnet Construct also offers secure connectivity to Magnet Enterprise web services for real-time data exchange from active project sites to and from the office. Magnet Construct is currently available on both the Apple App Store as well as Google Play. MapTix has finally been launched to the public. Maptix is like Google Analytics for web maps and currently integrates with Google Maps API, OpenLayers 3 and Leaflet.js. Most websites use Google Analytics for tracking their web activity, but user interaction tracking on a map doesn't exist. Maptix allows web developers and marketing teams to view user activities in detail, leading to a trove of new consumer insights. Maptix provides detailed map performance metrics as well.
The city of Henderson, North Carolina has chosen InnoWays' InfoWater software to support its geospatial water distribution network modeling and management needs. The move will help in addressing critical planning and operational issues with maximum effectiveness and optimize the city's capital improvement program. InfoWater's innovative network modeling technology addresses every facet of utility infrastructure management and protection, delivering the highest rate of return in the industry. Built atop SD's ArcGIS InfoWater seamlessly integrates sophisticated predictive analytics and optimization functionality directly within the powerful ArcGIS setting.